dear students, once again welcome back to Bosco Campus Session YouTube channel of Kottayam Don Bosco College. I am Raniyar, faculty member of PG Department of English. This time I am here with the paper European Fiction, which is the elective paper for MA Semester 3 students under Kerala University. So in this series, this is actually the fifth lecture of the series. In this series we are discussing the historical as well as literary background of Europe. In our previous classes, we covered Dark Ages, Middle Ages, Ancient Classical Period, Renaissance Period, Enlightenment Period and also Romantic Period. This time, we are discussing the Age of Realism and Naturalism. So, Realism and Naturalism, that this period, this period of Realism and Naturalism actually occurred as a reaction against Romanticism. So in Romanticism, if you go through the Romantic literature, you can understand that in Romantic literature you can see a lot of supernatural elements, fantastical elements, a lot of imaginations. Emotions are treated as something great in Romantic literature. So the literature, this period, Realism and Naturalism came into effect as a reaction against this Romanticism. This was a period in between the middle and end of 19th century. During this time, several changes occurred in social, political and also literary aspects of Europe. And it was during this time, industrial revolution resulted rapid urbanization and also certain advancement in the field of medicine. It is during this time population became suddenly grow and also photography was invented. Darwin's theories of evolution had a devastating impact on the religious faith of Europe during this time. And Bentham and Mill's utilitarianism, it promoted the idea of utility, that means the happiness of man. And it is during this time Marx and Engels, dialectical materialism and economic determinism drove the world to communist socialism. So all these changes pushed literature to the realistic and naturalistic tendency. And when we analyze the literature of Europe during this time, we can see that, as I mentioned, two major movements happened during this time. The first one was realism and the second one was naturalism. By the term realism, it suggests it was a movement. This movement portrayed life with all its fidelity. That means life depicts truthfully. That is the speciality of realism. When it comes to naturalism, in naturalism, it was a belief that every existing thing it is as part of nature. So that's explained by materialistically or naturally. So that was the speciality of naturalism. That means, once again, realism depicts subject as they appear in everyday life without any embellishments. Whereas this naturalism procured with ugliness. So, for example, in naturalistic literature, it presents criminal, fallen and marginalized, that means slum-dwelling people, their poverty, crime and even sex. It is presented very naturalistically in naturalistic literature. So both naturalism and realism reacted against romanticism, especially writing of historical fantasies, imaginations or idealistic things. And in literature, realism and naturalism found in novel and drama. This period produced many great novelists and also dramatists. There were good poets like Tennyson and Emily Dickinson. Essays like Matthew Arnold and Carlyle also appeared during this time. Actually, realism develops in two ways. The first one was social realism and the second one was psychological realism. In social realism actually emphasizes the accuracy of providing external details. For example, when you analyze the literature of Charles Dickens and also Leo Tolstoy, you can see some social realistic elements. Second one was the psychological realism. It depicts the complexity of the inner working of mind. George Eliot's and Dostoevsky's literature is an example for the psychological realism. And it was during this time in the field of literature, women novelists, especially Bronte sisters and also George Eliot came forward. So the writings of this Bronte sisters and George Eliot also enriched literature during the period of realism and naturalism. Now let's check who were the major writers of this period. During the time of realism and naturalism, European literature was enriched with the writings of great many prominent writers. From France, Balzac, Gustave Flaubert, Alexandre Dumas Perret, Alexandre Dumas Fils, Maupassant, Emile Zola, etc. were the prominent writers. Balzac was a great French novelist. He is considered as the father of modern realism. The romantic qualities of melodramatic plots and violent passions in scenes were the speciality of his writings. His famous novels are Eugene Grandet and Father Goriot. Gustave Flaubert was the greatest literary artist of the 19th century. His works are tinged with romanticism despite their realistic treatment. His works are the result of exactness and accuracy of observation and extreme impersonality and objectivity. Madame Bovary is his masterpiece, which is the showpiece of French realism. Alexandre Dumas Perret was a novelist and dramatist. He was known for his adventure novel, The Count of Monte Cristo. Alexandre Dumas Fils was the son of Perret. He was also a dramatist who wrote realistic works on moral and social problems. His successful play was The Lady of Camelias. Another important figure was Maupassant. He was a realistic short story writer. His short stories are pessimistic and morbid and mainly centered on Franco-Prussian War, bourgeois life in Paris, and high society in Paris. His best known short story was The Necklace. Emile Zola was considered as the founder and leader of French naturalism. In 1880, he published the experimental novel in which he explained his naturalistic method. For Emile Zola, the novelist is like the scientist performing an experiment. He is independent of moral conventions. He writes from careful observation and documentation, and he focuses on the force of heredity and environment. So these were the prominent writers from France during the time of realism and naturalism. From England also we have a number of writers. Charles Dickens was one of the important writers during the time of realism. He was a literary giant of Victorian England and most popular English novelist. He began his literary career with humorous and satiric caricatures. His famous novels are Oliver Twist, A Christmas Carol, David Copperfield, and A Tale of Two Cities. Three noted female novelists from England during this time were Bronte sisters, Charlotte Bronte, Emily Bronte, and Anne Bronte. The unhappy family life compelled these writers to write. Charlotte Bronte's Jane Eyre and Emily Bronte's Wuthering Heights were famous novels. William Makepeace Thackeray, another important writer, he initially wrote sketches and satires for magazines. He owed his success to the publications of The Book of Snobs and Vanity Fair in 1848. George Eliot was another writer. It was the pen name of Mary Ann Evans. She was the novelist of England. Her first novel was Adam Bede. Middlemarch is her finest novel. The Mill on the Floss is another important novel penned by George Eliot. The famous literary figure Thomas Hardy created a fictitious town, Wessex, in English literature. His famous novels include The Mayor of Casterbridge, Tess of Dubervilliers,
Jude the Obscure. Alfred Lord Tennyson was the representative poet of the Victorian England. His poetry reflects the sensibility of his time as well as the moral and intellectual values of his society. His famous works include Locksley Hall, Maud, The Princess, and Idylls of the King. In Memoriam is an elegy penned by Tennyson on the death of Arthur Hallam. Robert Browning was a Victorian poet. He was noted for employing the form of dramatic monologue. Porphyria's Lover, Fra Lippo Lippi, and My Last Duchess are his famous poems. Matthew Arnold was a renowned poet and critic who faced the age of change and transition with doubt and stoicism. His poetry expressed the plight of the Victorian court between two worlds, one dead and the other powerless to be born. His famous poems are The Scholar Gypsy, Thyrsis, Dover Beach, etc. George Bernard Shaw is a very famous literary Nobel laureate and he was a dramatist from Ireland. Like Henrik Ibsen, Shaw's plays are related to social problems. His famous plays include Arms and the Man, Candida, Mrs. Warren's Profession, Man and Superman, etc. Pygmalion was filmed into a successful musical comedy under the name My Fair Lady in 1956. From Russia also, we have a number of writers. The first important figure was Nikolai Gogol. He was the novelist and short story writer of Russia, and he was famous for his satirical comedy of mistaken identity. It was titled The Inspector General. Dead Souls was his novel. Fyodor Dostoevsky was one of the world's supreme masters of the realistic novel. He was noted for the acute and psychological perceptions in his characterization. His major novels are Crime and Punishment, The Brothers Karamazov, Notes from Underground, The Idiot, and The Possessed. Leo Tolstoy wrote novels, short stories, and plays. His writings often smack of his love for all mankind didacticism, as they express his belief in passive resistance to evil and in living simple, primitive life of physical labor as well as the condemnation of capitalism. His best known works are War and Peace and Anna Karenina. He had penned a novella under the title The Death of Ivanovich. Another important figure was Anton Chekhov. He was the short story writer. He initially wrote comic and satirical tales, but they were not as mature as his later pathetic short stories. His pathetic short stories were famous. Ward Number 6 and The Cherry Orchard are the famous short stories of Anton Chekhov. Maxim Gorky was the pseudonym of Alexei Maxinovich Sechelov Gorky. The Lower Depths is his best known dramatic work. He issues an autobiographical trilogy and developed his literary doctrine of social realism. From Scandinavia, we have a representative figure, Henrik Ibsen. He is called the father of modern drama. He wrote drama in verse and prose. He also penned a lot of problem plays like Bernard Shaw, which was under the themes of realistic and social problems.
By this, we can conclude that it is during the time of Victorian period, Europe witnessed a series of literary output on realism and naturalism. So it was a reaction against romanticism. And it is during this period, Europe witnessed the flourishing of modern drama and novels. Okay, my dear students, I am concluding now. I hope you understood an idea of this period, period of realism and naturalism. Please do the homework and send me back through WhatsApp. Thank you.